Hello everyone, hello again. I'm Phil here in my house and today we've got a live lesson and I think we said this was modals of ability to get what you want. And what that means is looking at how we use modals of ability, that's can and could, how we use them in sort of interpersonal ways, how we use them to talk to other people and perhaps in ways that you might not have seen before. Okay, just as always, a couple of things just before we start. I'm just going to mention that we're going to record this whole lesson. So if you miss anything, do not worry. You'll get it all again at the end. And let's just put, while I'm explaining this, let's just put some questions up for you to have a look at while I'm talking about it. Okay, so we've got some sentences here. They've all got mistakes in them. They're all wrong. Can you fix them? Can you think what they are? Okay, this question, like any others, you can answer in the comments wherever you're watching. Please do use the comments, say hello, say where you're watching from, and also use them to answer questions. So, for example, Vina has said hi from Kurdistan, and Anna has said hi from Vietnam, and Gurvinda has said hi from India. Okay, please do tell me where you're watching from. I'm in London, in England at the moment. Okay, if you have just joined in, these are questions. Use the comments to tell me what they should say. They're all wrong. All of these sentences are all wrong. And we're going to get onto why in a minute. Okay, another thing to remember is you can always invite your friends to this. It's a live lesson, so invite them. They can join in straight away, so please do. Also, even if it's not live, even if you're watching the replay, hello to everyone watching the replay. We love all our replay viewers. You can also share the lesson as well. And you can share it afterwards. Okay, so without further ado, let's have a look. We're looking at these sentences. They've all got modal verbs in them, modals of ability, and then we're trying to use them in these interpersonal ways, but there's a problem with all of them. Can you see the problems in these sentences? What should they say? And I haven't put numbers on them, but maybe they should have numbers on. If you want to say 1, 2, and 3, when you're answering, I'll know exactly which one you mean. Don't worry. I've got a suggestion here already straight away. Jessica is saying, can you get that for me? Can you get that for me? Okay. Yeah. Can you get that for me? Okay. Can you get that for me? If we're making a request, we'll probably use can for that. Can you get that for me? Okay. Is the one we usually use to make requests. What about number two? Can't you leave things in the way in future? Can't you leave things in the way in future? What could that be? What should that be? What do you think the answer is? Actually, I just say a few hi's to people. So hello to Fan Ficcion from Mexico. Hello to, we've got a few more hellos coming in. Hello to Mohammed from Somalia. Hello to Ellie from Iran. If you have just joined us, this is a live lesson from BBC Learning English. And we're looking at modals of ability and how we can use them kind of to get what you want or to say certain things. Okay, we said that all of these sentences, they've got a mistake in them. What do you think the mistake would be? Okay, we've got a few suggestions for number two. Can't you leave things in the way in future? Any ideas? But a few answers. I can't see, the answer is, and we'll say why in a little bit, can you not leave things in the way in future? Is a request for someone not to do something. I haven't seen anyone say that in the comments. Apologies if I've missed your comment. You may well have said it. We've got lots of comments coming in, which is great, and do keep them coming in. But we'll have a look and see why it's, can you not leave things in the way in future? Okay, and I can see a few now. I can see in the comments. I can see Alex has said that, can you not leave things in the future? Okay, and we'll look at why we say it like that. Well, in the future, later in the lesson. Okay, can you to let me know if she calls? Is there anything wrong with that? Well, I've already told you there's something wrong with it. What's wrong with it? What should it be? Can you to let me know if she calls? What do you think that should be? Ah, Hugo's got it right. Can you let me know if she calls? Can you let me know if she calls? Okay, so yes, modal verbs. Do remember, after modal verbs, we don't use to. Okay, we're just using the verb afterwards. Can you let me know? That's the answer. I'll just hide that comment and let's have a look. So we're looking here at modals of ability for requests. And there's a few things that we need to remember about them. One of them, so if we look here, can you listen for a minute? Could you listen for a minute? That's a request, okay? What it isn't is it's not a question. Okay, it's not a question. Can you listen for a minute? Yes, I can. It's not the answer that you want to get when you're saying it. What this actually is a request. We're asking someone to listen for a minute. Please listen for a minute. We get the same result. So we use this modal ability. We do use a question mark, but it's not a question. Okay, it's not a question. It's a request in this case. And we'll look at some examples in a minute so you can work out which are questions and which are requests. You can use can or could with them. Can you listen for a minute? Could you listen for a minute? And could is, I'm going to say, sometimes more polite. We usually say that could is a more polite form of can. It's not the past here. We often say that it's a more polite form, but it might depend how someone's saying it. Okay, if someone says, could you listen? Then it's not really polite, okay, even though they've used the word. So politeness comes from lots of places. But yes, if you use could, it can be more polite. But it might depend who's saying it, where they're saying it, how they're saying it. It might depend on lots of other things. So do remember. Okay. excellent. Let's have a look what else we can say about it. Yes, the negative, and there was an example we just looked at there, and we'll look more at negatives in the next section, is using can, could, and using can and could, you, and then not. And we'll have a look at a few things around how we do it when it's a negative in a minute. Okay, lots of explanation there. Let's give you an exercise so you can check out in the comments. We have a look here. Here, we've got four sentences. Maybe I need to make them a little bit bigger. They're a little bit small, so hold on a second. Maybe you can see them a little bit better here. Some of them are requests and some of them are questions. Sorry, our logo is covering that slightly, but some are requests and some are questions. I want you to look at these four sentences and I want you to decide, is it a request or is it a question? Okay, is it a request or is it a question? They're actually pairs of sentences. So for example, number one, there's a job here in Paris. Can you speak French? Is that a request or is it a question? Can you say that again in English? I don't speak French. Is that a request or is it a question? Number three, could you play football well when you were younger? Is that a request or is it a question? And number four, it'd be great to play football. Could you bring a ball? Is that a request or is it a question? Have a look and have a think. Are they requests or are they questions? I can see the comments coming in already. So thank you so much for joining in. I could also see we've just posted a link to the worksheet. So if you do want to get more practice on this, we've got a worksheet and you'll see the link in the comments. I'm sure we'll post it again, but it's there. The link is there if you need it. Okay, I can see lots of people answering this. So let's have a look at some of the answers. Right, number one, there's a job here in Paris. Can you speak French? Can you speak French? Yeah, there's an obvious answer to it, isn't there? Which is, yes, I can speak French. I can't really speak French, but yes, I can speak French would be an answer. So if it's got an answer, it's going to be a question. There's a job here in Paris. Can you speak French? So we're not really looking too much at the questions here today. We're looking at requests. Let's have a look at number two. Is it a question or a request? Can you say that again in English? I don't speak French. Can you say that again in English? I don't speak French. Let's have a look in the comments. Marceline is saying that it's a request. I'm seeing who else. We've got so many here. Miklenda, apologies if I pronounce your name wrong. I'm really sorry. Mikendla is saying it's a request. Kozui is also saying it's a request, as is Damaris. Okay, and there's lots more answers. Sorry, I can't go through all your comments, but yes, it's a request. Can you say that again in English? I don't speak French. Okay, it's a request. They're not asking you to say, yes, I can say that in English. They don't want to know that. What they want is for you to do it. So it's not a question, it's a request. And that's what we're looking at today. Number three here, we've got, could you play football well when you were younger? Could you play football well when you were younger? Is that a question or a request? Can't say it, request. Number three, I can see Matthias says that number three is a question. Maria also says that number three is a question. Loads of comments flowing in. Natasha has said there's a question. I can see Yevgeny also. Yevgeny saying it might be a request. Ooh, we've got different answers. Let's have a look. Here's a question, Marita says. Okay, let's have a look. Okay, number three, it is a question. Could you play football well when you were younger? I couldn't, by the way. I was rubbish at football when I was younger. I'm even worse now. But could you play football when you were younger? It's a question. There's an answer to it. Could here is actually talking about the past. This isn't about being more polite. It's referring to when I was younger and I could still run a bit faster than I can now. So could you play football well when I was younger? It has an answer. Yes, I could play football well when I was younger. I can't anymore. Okay. I couldn't really then either, but never mind. Okay. So that leaves us number four. You might be able to work out from the shape on here. It'd be great to play football. Could you bring a ball? Is that a question? Or is it a request? What do you think? And I'm sure I've seen loads of questions. I'm sure lots of you have already answered question four. We're actually saying it's a question. In fact, I'm saying it's a request. Lynn is saying it's a request. Alexander is saying it's a request. Oh, sorry, wrong comment. In fact, I'm saying it's a request. Okay, let's have a look. Okay, yeah, it's a request. It'd be great to play football. Could you bring a ball? They're not asking whether you're able to in this case. What they want to know is if you, what they want you to do is to look for a ball at home and bring it so that you can play football. It's a request. It's using could because, as we said, it can be more polite if you use could. Okay, as we said before, politeness does depend on quite a lot of things. Okay, excellent. Great answers, everyone. Really good. Lots of them are correct. I want to hand over to you now. I want to get you to do a little bit more work, and I'm going to ask for some examples. I'm just going to make this slightly smaller, and let's have a look at the next slide. I want you to think about if you're planning a party at work. Now, if you're doing that, you're probably going to need to ask people for things. Okay, and you can put your requests using modals of ability into the comments, which you've been doing really well so far. And these are things you might want to think about. So, what help do you need? You're planning a party at work. What help do you need? What things do you need people to do for you? What do you need to plan? What do you need to get ready? So, you might need to, when you're thinking about things, you might ask other people to get things. Who do you need to speak to? Who do you need to speak to? Okay, maybe there are people you need to talk to be able to get this party to work well. I'm sure you're all great party planners. Okay, and we got another one. Yes, the last one. What do people need to bring with them? Have a think and see if you can write some requests in the comments. Okay, see if you can write some lists, some links, some up. I'll try that again. See if you can write some requests in the comments. Okay, so I've got some examples that you could use. So, for example, we could say something like, you might want to ask someone, could you sort out the music? And that sort out just means to arrange. Could you sort out the music? What other things might we ask people to do? Whatever things. Oh, Kumaresan saying, could you please help me get the stuff ready for a party? Yeah, could you please help me to get ready? Can you help me to cook food? Says Shiloh. Really good. Okay. Sergey saying, could you help me with perhaps tidying up? Could you help me with the tidying up? Yeah, a great request. Could you bring a canopy or a canapé, like little bits of food to the party? Yes. Kian, could you serve the rice for all the guests, maybe during the party? Yeah, could you serve the rice? Brilliant. Great one there, Kian. Okay, again, apologies if I pronounce your name wrong. Oh, Nadika, could you please make some cupcakes? Love cupcakes. Always good to have cupcakes. Could you please make some cupcakes? Very nice. And the please there makes it really polite, along with the could. Yevgeny said, could you please bring some balloons? Yeah, what's a party without balloons, eh? Could you please bring some balloons? Okay. Could you make a list of all the workmates? Could you make a list of everyone so we know who to ask? Yeah, another great request. Okay. Fantastic, brilliant comments. Okay, let's have a look now. Let's move on. There's some really good examples there. Let's move on and let's have a look at negative requests, which we talked about. A negative request and negative ability sometimes can look very similar. So we're going to have a look and see if we can see the difference of them. Let me give you some examples to make it clearer. Okay. Can you not play the guitar? Now that could be Can you not play the guitar? Or can you not play the guitar? And the meaning is different. We'll talk about that in a minute. There's two different ways you can do it. So for example, can you not play the guitar? Can you not play the guitar? That might just mean, might just be talking about abilities. Like, I thought you could play the guitar and I'm surprised you can't. All right. It's not a request. That they was talking about ability. But we could say, use the same words. So we might say them slightly differently, but we could also say, can you not play the guitar? Or can you not play the guitar right now because it's really late? Okay, so that's a negative request. Can you not do that? Okay, you'll notice it uses the same words as talking about ability as well. So look for the context and be careful, but there are some other things that you can listen out for. So for negative requests, we don't ever say, can't you, when we make them. Can't you play the guitar? Always means the first one. It always means, I thought you could play the guitar and I'm a bit surprised. It doesn't mean stop it, it's late. So if it's can't you, it's only talking about ability. It's not a request. Okay. It's also where the stress is. Okay. When we say, when we're making a request, the stress is very strongly on the not. So can you not play the guitar? Can you not play the guitar? Which sounds very differently to, can you not play the guitar? When we talk about ability, the stress is probably more strong, is probably stronger on the verb. Whereas actually, when we're talking, when we're making a negative request, the not is very heavily stressed. So you can probably hear the difference there. And before, as before, we can use can and we can use could. We can use both of them. And as people have mentioned, sorry, hide that banner. As people have mentioned, could is probably a bit more polite. Again, depending on how you say it, who you're saying it to, and all these other things. Okay, if you've just joined us, this is BBC Learning English, and this is a live lesson looking at modals of ability and how we can use them to make requests, to get what you want, is what we said in the title. My name's Phil, I'm here in London. Just a reminder, this whole lesson will be live. Well, after we finish being live, it will be recorded on our website, so you can look and go over any questions that you want to have a look at again. But we're looking at negative requests and negative ability. So let's have a little look here and see if you can spot the difference. Very similar to how we did before. And again, I'll make it a bit bigger. It's quite small. We've got requests and we've got questions. Okay, we've got requests and we've got questions. So have a read of them. 1, 2, 3, 4. Do you think, put the number of whether you think it's a request or a question. Okay, so can you not eat that here? It's making a mess. Is that a request or is that a question? What do you think? Can you not eat that? Are you allergic? Is that a request or is it a question? Do you want someone to do something or do you want some information? Can you not play chess? Let me teach you. Okay, is that a request or is it a question? Could you not play that here? It's really noisy. Again, is that a request or a question? Do you want information or do you want someone to stop doing something? You'll see that they're all can or could you not. Okay, you'll see that there's can and could you not in there. Use that, but use the context to help you. Oh, I can see some answers coming in already. Don't let that put you off. If you haven't answered yet, do join in and add your answers. Please do. Just a quick reminder, of course, you can invite people to join the lesson. You can share it with other people if you want to. Okay. Let's have a look. What are we going to do for number one? Can you not eat that here? It's making a mess. Shailu says it's a request. Lally 2 says it's a request. Who else has answered for number one? Nadika, who we saw before, said it's a request. Abdul Rashid says it's a request. Is that Madame Garnier says it's a request. Monica also saying it's a request. Let's have a look. Let's see what it is. Can you not eat that here? It's making a mess. Okay. Yeah, it's a request. You're going to hear stress on the not. Can you not eat that here? It's making a mess. Okay. You hear the stress more than the not. We can't say, can't you? We can't say, can't you eat that here? It's making a mess. It has a completely different meaning and it doesn't work. So you can't use can't you here. Okay. The contraction would change the meaning. So we can't use it on this one. Okay, great. Let's have a look at number two. And I can see lots of answers already for number two, but if you haven't answered, put what you think. Can you not eat that? Are you allergic? Is that a request or is it a question? What do you think? Sylvia thinks it's a question. Huda thinks it's a question. Loredana thinks it's a question. Vilma thinks it's a question. Sorry, thinks it's a question. What do you think? What does everyone think? It's a question. Can you not eat that? Are you allergic? Okay. So we often use this structure when we're a little bit surprised. Can you not eat that? I thought it was fine. Oh, are you allergic? Right, I'll get something else. Well, are you vegetarian? Or things like that. Something that you didn't expect. And we can use can't you here. When it's a question like this, you say, can't you eat that? Oh, sorry. It could be, are you allergic? Are you vegetarian? All kinds of reasons. But there is that idea that you're a little bit surprised, which is a little bit unexpected when we say it. Okay. But it's not a request. It's a question here. We want the information. Oh, can you not eat that? Oh, don't worry. I'll get something else. Okay, great. Everyone got the right answer there that I saw, so that's really good. So let's have a look at number three. Okay, same idea. Can you not play chess? Let me teach you. Can you not play chess? Let me teach you. What do you think it is? Number three, is it a request or a question? What do you reckon? I can see that Saulzen, apologies if I get that wrong, Saulzen said it's a question for number three. I can see loads more comments coming in. Great, keep them coming. Nino is also saying it's a question. Tran saying it's a request. Mako saying it's a question. Yamba says it's a request. Fuang saying it's a question. Monica says it's a question. Okay, let's find out. Can you not play chess? Let me teach you. It's a question. You're asking for information. Okay, you're asking for it. I'm going to drink some water from my lovely BBC Learning English cup. Yes, it's a question. They're asking for information. Can you not play chess? It's a question. So the answer will be, yeah, no, I can't, probably. Let me teach you. Okay, again, they're slightly surprised. And they can use can't you here. Can't you play chess? No problem. I'll teach you. Okay, so this one is a question. So that leaves us with number four. Maybe the space makes it a bit obvious, but let's see what people have said for number four. Shu has said that number four is a request. Lin has said that number four is a request. Mile has said that number four is a request. Mako has said that it's a request. Okay. Asad has said it's a request. Let's have a look. Let's see. Okay. Could you not play that here? It's really noisy. Yeah. It's a request. They're using could. They're probably trying to be polite. It's a request. Could you not play that here? It's noisy. Do it somewhere else. Can you not play that? You could use can as well. Can you not play that here? It's really noisy. Okay, so we can use, you can see we can use could or we can use can in the requests. The form is the same as how we use it in the question. It's the context that will give it away and possibly also the way the person is stressing it. Okay, and if you see can't you, it's not a request, it's a question. Okay, and the context will be different. It's talking about surprise rather than a request not to do something. Okay, right. I've got another challenge for you. So let's have a look at the next thing. Similar to before, but we've got a different situation. You're living with the worst flatmate you can imagine. A flatmate is someone who lives with you in a flat. Possibly someone you're related to, might just be a friend, might just be, it could be lots of reasons that you live with someone. And we're going to imagine, I'm sure it's not true, but we're going to imagine you're living with the worst flatmate. And there's things that they do to annoy you. How do they annoy you? Think first, how do they annoy you? What do you want them to stop doing? Okay, and I want you to put in the comments what you want them to stop doing. Have a think. Using this can you not or could you not, what things would you say to somebody who is possibly the worst person to live with? Okay, what would you say? Let's have a look. I'm going to bring up some examples I've got here. It was a big one. So when I was a student and shared houses with people, can you not leave the kitchen untidy? Can you not leave the kitchen untidy? There's one example. What else could we say? Maybe, could you not have parties without telling me? I was trying to get to sleep. Could you not have parties without telling me? Perhaps link to that. Could you not sing karaoke at 3 a.m. every night? Could you not sing karaoke at 3 a.m. every night? What things do you want the worst flatmate to stop doing? Oh, this is a request, a positive one, but yeah, can you clean up after eating? Yevgeny said, can you not make such noise? Great one here from Zweli. Could you not smoke here? Can you stop eating in the living room? Which we could also say is, can you not eat in the living room? It makes a mess. We've got to tidy it up. Claudia saying, could you not be so noisy, please? Okay, yeah, very important when you're living with someone. Could you not be so noisy, please? Have we got any others? Can you, Abdullah saying, can you not play music at night? Yes, great one. Can you not play music at night? We're often quite annoyed when we say these things. Can you not ignore my messages? Can you not ignore my message? I keep telling you to be quiet, clean up the kitchen, whatever. Can you not ignore my message? Can you not make a mess? Could you not be a little bit more sensible? That's a really good one, that one. I like that one from Sandeep. Could you not be a little bit more sensible? It's brilliant. A few of these are positive requests, but they're fine. Could you stop watching that horrible film? It's scaring me. Could you stop watching that horrible film? Well, we've got a situation here from Sikleng. You've been talking on the phone the whole night. Can you not speak at night? Can you not talk to your friends in the middle of the night? I need to sleep. Ooh. Could you keep your mouth shut when you're watching the movie? Or could you keep quiet when you're watching the movie? Yes, lovely request. Dora said, could you stop being untidy? Could you not be untidy all the time? Yep. Could you not switch off the lights? Or it could be, could you not switch on the lights, depending on how you like it or what you want it to be? Again, similar theme here from Eleanor. Could you please not make noises at night? Any others? Just before, we'll go for a few more. Remember, we do have a worksheet so you can get more practice on all of these. And you see it here. You should be able to download it from the link in the comments. This whole lesson will be posted up on our Facebook and YouTube feeds. As soon as we finish, you can watch it again and again. And, of course, share it with whoever you want. We have these live English classes every Wednesday for our grammar class. But we also have pronunciation classes and vocabulary classes throughout the week on different channels. I'm going to have a look at some more of your examples. Another Sarita, can you not smoke inside? Can you not smoke inside? Can you stop being so rude? We've got loads of complaints here. Can you not cook at night time, says Layla. Okay, yeah, it's really hard to sleep when someone's banging pots and pans. Could you not cook at night time? Could you clean your room sometimes, says Sueli. Jensen, can you stop annoying me, please? Okay, lots of great examples here. Could you stop laughing loudly? Okay, maybe that's annoying. Could you stop laughing loudly? Could you stop snoring loudly while I was sleeping? A nice one from Hugo. It's annoying hearing you chew that loud. Could you not chew with your mouth open? Ooh. Another great one here from Zain Harati. Could you not use my towel again? Use your own one. It got dirty. Bill's like, could you not spend all my money? Okay, maybe. Can you not stay up late this weekend? I've got a really important exam. I need to study for it. Can you not stay up late? Okay, I need to get a good night's sleep. Well, I've got a new job. Excellent one, Liliana. That's brilliant. Nina said, can you not watch TV at night? We could have there from Nina's example. Yes, brilliant. Okay, thank you so much for all your sentences. There's loads coming in and they're still coming in. And do, if you're watching the replay, please add more. Share it with the other people in the comments. Please do. I'll see you next time. Thank you so much. And we'll see you next time. Bye.